adjust this notch. Horseweed on cottonwood. Stone peck bearing block. Now, one thing about spindles like this, lots of unevenness and bumpiness and a little bit crooked there. You don't want to carve away too much of the exterior wood, you know, because it disrupts its integrity, so it's not going to be as strong. So I had a hole in these, which is very common with pithy plants like this. So I just cut off some of the little or smaller stems at the top and just stuffed them in there, and they were solid pith. They were very tiny and fragile, but they filled the hole nicely, and you can see it's still filled. So I also use paracord with the bow, which when you have spindles like this, paracord is so much more forgiving, but you got to be careful with your notch. You know, I made my notch a little, my divot a little deeper, my divot, so it could hold, and I started out not making my notch as big and as deep, because I just wanted to do my best to keep it in there, because when it's bent like this towards that end and uneven, you can only have so much area on there to spin it with. It wants to pop out on you. So it took me a little bit to figure that out, which I do all the time. So not that difficult. Just take my time and just figure out what it wants to keep it in there. But you know, you could spend more time smoothing this out. You know, if you got a Leatherman file or sandpaper or sandstone or whatever, you know, and you can smooth this more out with your knife or whatever and straighten it out more. I mean, I could have cut it off right here and got rid of that bent end, but I don't know what it looks like up here. And I knew that I had a lot of these stem bumps, which would have made it hard to spin even with paracord. So I had my smoothest area down here, my largest area of exterior wood. So I just went with that and, you know, was able to get it to work. Also up here, you can see the pith closed in a little bit, but it was also a big hole and hollow up there. Even when I stuffed that in down here, it felt hollow way up there. I mean, it kept going, and then it kind of started pushing the pith up. So I just stopped. But down here, instead of making it real sharp and pointy for less friction at the top at the bearing block end like you normally do, you know, with my stone bearing block, and this being fragile, I didn't want to get rid of the more exterior wood because it's fragile, like I said, and it could just break on you. So with a stone bearing block, or if you have a metal one, I'm sure it would be just fine leaving it like this, and you don't need a long point, but you have to, you know, adjust your pressure and everything. But it smoothed it out, didn't have any issues up here at the bearing block end. So Horseweed makes an excellent hand drill. I rarely find a big huge stem like this. This was an old plant that avoided mowing, you know, so it worked out perfectly for a large bow drill spindle. You can also use the smaller stems and bundle them, you know, tie them in a big bundle. If you don't have a large enough stem, tie them in a bundle and tight together, and then you could, you know, do a bundle spindle if you don't have one large like this. Otherwise, just use the hand drill method. Horseweed on cottonwood.